Well, anyway, Dave up 2-0 over Fez this morning. Very, very surprising, Fez. You agree with him. He doesn't agree with you.
I disagreed with him.
Are you guys
in a lot of principles?
Are you guys getting along now? Do you feel like you're getting along better?
No, I don't feel it at all.
I do.
What is this? That can only signify one thing. The Batman trivia test is about to take place.
Ah, nice. All right. Had no idea.
Remember you guys called out each other?
Uh-huh.
There was a contest. We said it would either be about Batman or Star Wars. What was the bet, boys?
I believe I was going to have to shave my beard again.
So what should the bet be now? A kiss my ass match?
Kiss my ass match. Yes.
Kiss
yes,
my ass
kiss
match.
My I'll do kiss my kiss ass,
ass
match.
Kiss my ass.
Kiss my ass.
Oh, this is awesome.
I'm in on that.
This is totally shocking.
Yeah, this is a shocker. Batman trivia, and we said just the movies.
Okay.
Just the movies.
Damn it, I should have boned up for this.
I wouldn't let you. That's why I said it could be about three different things.
It's smart.
I said it could also be about Star Wars or a potpourri.
You should each take a cowbell. Cowbell and a pen.
All right.
Fezzy, let's hear your cowbell. And you just threw your pen. Dave, let's hear your cowbell. All right, enough of a difference there. Hicks, I need you to also be able to do judge on cowbell. We've got a bunch of Batman movie questions. Let's do this. First person to, we'll say seven. How's that sound?
Sounds good to me.
Great.
Seven?
Great.
Here we go. Name all the Batman movie titles in order. Dave got it first. Go ahead.
Batman. Batman Returns. Batman Forever. Batman and Robin. Batman Begins. The Dark Knight.
Sorry.
What did I do?
Fezzy, would you like to try now?
Yes, I would.
Go ahead, Fezzy.
Batman the Movie. Batman. Batman Returns. Batman Forever. Batman and Robin. Batman Begins. The Dark Knight.
That's the original. Damn. Fucking stupid.
What was the name of the poison gas the Joker used in... Says what was it?
Smilex.
Psilocybin.
Fez Watley jumps out here to an enormous 2-0 lead. An enormous 2-0 lead. Who was originally cast as Vicki Vale, but was replaced after she broke her collarbone on a horse riding scene? Dave McDonald.
This is a guess, but I'm going to say Michelle Pfeiffer.
Fez Watley.
Sigourney Weaver.
It was Sean Young.
Sean Young. Damn it. Damn it.
That actually didn't make the movies, but would have been like a little extra trivia.
It was.
Just to see if you guys like to read movie magazines about Batman movies. Fez Watley, you're off to a 2-0 lead. How you feeling?
Yes, I'm feeling very good about this.
If you win, he'll hit his knees, kiss your bare ass.
That's right. I will drop the boxers to produce the bare ass for Dave to kiss.
You'll deuce the bare ass. I don't know why he's going to douche, but maybe he needs to. Let's move on here. In Batman Forever, Who is Bruce Wayne's love interest?
Nicole Kidman, the psychiatrist.
Her name, please. Her character's name. Bruce Wayne's. Says what?
Dr. Chase Meridian.
We asked for Bruce Wayne's love interest. 3-0.
Okay.
About to bring shame and embarrassment. Fezzi, would you be willing to let him out of this right now?
No, not at all.
Is there anything else you'd rather have? Dave, if you're seeing kissing his ass, I don't see how you could ever fucking hold your head up again.
It's all part of the game. And I'm Eli Manning, baby. Cool as a cucumber. I was down before, I'll be down again.
In the Batman films, what is Drew Barrymore's character's name? Dave.
Sugar. This is where the Derek Jeter in me comes out. You'll see the clutch.
What is the name of Robin's motorcycle? Fez Watley.
Redbird.
Fez Watley with a shocker. A shocker. I am embarrassed. Somebody knows the name of Robin's motorcycle.
That was it.
It's a kiss my ass match. It's a kiss my ass match. Let's go to the Dark Knight for you younger kids.
Great.
What is the name of Eric Roberts' character? Well, that was close.
I think that was Fez.
Fezzy?
Sal Maroney.
No!
Why, what did you have it as?
Tomasino.
It's Salvatore Maroney. I'm going to give it to
Salvatore?
Him. Sal Maroney. Fezzy, you need what? Two more?
Two more. It is 5-1 in favor of Fez.
This is the first time in the history of the Sam and Dave show that Sam or Dave has trailed so badly.
Comebacks are made to be broken. You know.
Let's head on over here.
I should stop singing the Batman song in my head. I think that's hurting
me. Let's go to Batman Begins.
Okay.
When Bruce Wayne realizes he needs wheels, he finds a vehicle in Lucius Fox's division. What does Fox call that vehicle?
The tank.
The tank. Fezzy.
I remember the scene, the Predator?
How could you not know this? It's the Tumbler.
The Tumbler.
You know what? If you guys don't even want to do this,
I knew
yeah,
well,
no, we
want to
do it.
I'm not even going to move on.
I'm up 5-1.
I'm just going to move on.
I knew
no,
it was
we got to finish.
I knew it was a T.
Fucking figure it out. If you don't know the Tumbler, you don't even know these fucking
I knew
films.
It was a T. That's my thing.
Let's just move on to news here.
Yeah.
In the news today.
No, we have to finish the Batman quiz.
Well, I mean,
I'm so close to winning a kiss my ass match.
I mean, if you want to go to the news, you know, maybe.
Very, very surprised here. After Dick, and let's go to Batman Forever. After Dick saves Batman, he suggests two possible sidekick nicknames. Fezzy?
Nightwing or Batboy?
I was going to say the Riddler. So I'm off.
Call me the Riddler.
I'm just off.
I'm the Riddler. It's 6-1.
I'm not going to name after one of my villains.
Wait, Ron, is it win by two?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
Got to win by two.
This is where I need one of those rock and jock 10-point home run fucking softballs. I'm not quitting, though. Davey Mack never quits. Here we go.
You want to make this worth 8 points?
No.
Yes. That would be great.
All right, let's go back to Batman and Robin. What singer / rapper had a small role as banker?
That was Dave.
Ludacris.
Fez Watley.
Coolio, Ron. Coolio.
This is for the win?
No. Don't hit it.
This is for the winner of the Kiss My Ass
MC
match.
MC Coolio is his name, right?
No! No! Don't hit it again! No, no!
If there's two things I know, it's Batman and rap.
Fez Watley crushes Eastside Dave McDonald.
The Riddler.
It's over.
Please.
Dave. And in a devastating fashion, 7-1. Devastating.
No excuse.
I own that competition.
Ronnie, we just didn't have our A stuff today.
You sure didn't.
I mean, listen, sometimes you get a hit.
HTG actually put these questions together.
Brilliant, HTG. Great questions.
She said this to me. Let me slant this Watley's way. Let me slant this old school. Fezzy, when he got every one of the names first, but did not realize that Adam West had done a movie, and you came back and picked up on it, I thought to myself, this fucker's over. This thing is over. It's an all-new age of Fez Watley. Fez Watley, year one. Mike, in D.C., you're on Ron and Fez show.
Ron, I got to call back to revive my Ichiban.
Yeah.
The Ichiban now has to be that Fez Watley has finally won something.
He won a Kiss My Ass match?
The streak is alive there, Mike.
We have to. And by the way, from D.C., I meant D.C. Comics.
One doesn't make a streak, Fez.
It's just the beginning, baby.
Here is Sean in PA. Sean, how are you, buddy?
Fez Watley's back. Woo!
I don't even know if I'd say he's back. It's an all new Fez Watley. Fez Watley, year one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just the beginning. Yeah, one victory, and you know what? The building block that we build everything else off of. This was perfect. Tried to take me on in my home turf, the Batcave. Didn't happen. Not even close.
Now, did this start off, as we said, would either be Batman or Star Wars?
Yeah.
You feel like you would have done a lot better at Star Wars, Dave?
I feel like Star Wars is definitely better. It's more suited to me.
Look at your confidence level.
Let me just say this. I'm not a poor sport. He beat me today. He was the better person.
That sounds really poor to me.
You think that Fez would have been a poor sport if he would have won?
Yes.
Fez, we're going to have this picture taken today, sent over to Mikey Boy to post on what you now call the hater board, because you said you've just lost RonFez.net to Dave.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's just gone. That's fine. Everyone against me, line up with Dave. Sure.
Mike, you're on the Ron Fez show.
Hey, man, Fez McCool is back in town.
You can't take anything away from him.
You gotta be cool to know that much Batman trivia.
You know a couple even embarrassing ones, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
Some of those were slightly embarrassing.
Yeah, Redbird engage.
Redbird was...
Disengage Redbird.
When I even read that, I fucking cringed. I cringed.
Redbird is different from a Robin, too. Why would they even do that? Why not just call it, like, the Robin bike?
Walker in New Jersey.
Dick Holder, 1229. Hey, Fezzy, did you just say your home turf is the Batcave? I thought it was the Man Cave.
You know what? The Fez Watley...
Can't take it away from me today, can you?
Fez Watley jokes were yesterday, my friend.
Yeah, if that guy wants to take me on a Batman trivia, that's fine.
That's enough, big man. Come on.
I'll do it all day long if I have to.
Put your brain away. Put your brain away. You don't need it. Let's go over here to Andy. Andy, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, guys. So I got to ask a question. Is this Fez Returns or Fez Begins?
What would you say, Fez?
I'd say it's more Fez Begins.
Let's light the Fez signal.
Oh, I'm here. You don't have to light the signal. I'm already here.
Fez, which one of those guys would be you? which one of the actors would play you if we were doing the Fez Watley movie? You could take any of them.
I think it probably would be Val Kilmer, the very aloof Val Kilmer.
I've seen you more as the guy who played King Tut. He would be perfect for
Big
you.
Fat Victor Bono?
Yeah, he would be perfect for you.
Victor Bono.
Here is Colin in Jersey.
Riddler.
Fezzy McCool, wheeling and dealing.
Here
I
is,
love you, Petty Mac.
It's a big day. I'm not gonna try to downplay it at all. It's a big, big day, and I feel good.
Here's Coke Logic.
Hey, Dave, I want to thank you, man. Thanks for throwing the game. Fez really needed this victory.
Did you throw the game?
No. But I appreciate your support, Coke Logic.
Eric in New York.
What's next for Fez 2.0?
Well, probably marching through a Star Wars competition. Just marching right on through like a big at-at.
And that's going to be kiss My Ballsack. That is coming soon.
I'll do that then.
Let's do it.
You're up for Kiss My Ballsack?
Yeah. On Star Wars? Of course.
Maybe Star Wars. Maybe something else. You never know. When that alarm goes off,
yeah. You
guys will be competing.
I didn't know what it was. I was ready to head to the exits. I didn't know what was going on in the building.
Could be Star Wars. Could be baseball trivia.
Oh, God. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
I never know
please,
how this is going to go down.
Please do the baseball trivia. I'll do a suck my cock competition in baseball trivia. I will do a suck my cock.
But in your own?
In your case, it's a no lose. You're happy with either. Here is Rob. Rob, you're on Run of Fez.
I was just going to say, way to get back in there, Ope. Way to get back on your feet.
You know how lame that joke sounds now after I just crushed in a Batman trivia competition? It deflects. It's yesterday's news, kiddo.
Mike, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Hey, Ronnie. Notice how Fez wins the one competition that involves gay love. Hey, Dave, you going to finger pop him while you're kissing his ass?
If he wants. I lost fair and square. I'm not going to make excuses to him.
Robo Artist, you're on Run of Fez.
Ron, in honor of Fez's comeback today, I'm going to make a new front page heralding the return of Fez Year One, Fez the Beginning.
Well, Fez, really, we'll send the picture over in a little bit of the Kiss My Ass, where
sure.
Dave will be kissing the fur on Watley's ass.
I'm going to put an extra coat of chapstick on right now.
They all come crawling back.
Is that extra sweet for you, Fez, that this has to go up on runfez.net? The site that you no longer like?
Exactly, yeah. The site that worships Eastside Dave? Yeah. Here's your king. Here's your mighty ruler. Here's your supreme leader on his knees kissing my dimpled ass.
Is that dimpled or pimpled?
Little of each.
He's not a graceful winner.
No, he definitely isn't. He definitely is
not. I don't think I'd be boasting like this.
I've never seen you lose a competition on the show. Well, what else? Oh, you lost. Search, hurry up and search. And that was it.
Yeah. I lost one thing to... I lost Beard Wars to Fez.
Mm. So you have to...
It's all hurting. It's all adding up.
You've got to kiss Fez's cellulite ass.
Mm-hmm. But it's not like the Yankees Red Sox. He has had some wicked wins, so have I. This was not one of them. Listen, I came...
I'm going to pick the cheek, too, where I have a little varicose vein action working.
That's sick. Oh, God.
I don't know what causes that.
Keep in mind, I didn't brush my teeth today. I'm very dirty.
So you feel like you're getting even with him?
I'm going to lick. I'm going to lick it.
By the way, I come in here today, and he goes... Hey, I have a Fez bit ready to go.
Mm-hmm.
He had a Fez bit ready to go.
Really?
You still want to play it, big man, or are you too embarrassed?
Does this feel like the day?
You want to save it for a day that he's down.
That's a good point. It's your call.
No.
We're so indecisive now. Usually we don't take a pause if there's a chance to come after Fez and disrespect him on his own show.
Well, I think it's appropriate.
We are shaking here.
Graceful in defeat.
Yeah, you'd have
to. I guess you really have no choice.
People call me the Jack Nicklaus
of radio. Didn't he play the Joker? according to you?
No, that was
is that one of the questions you missed?
Talking about the golfer. Well, I thought that Robin, I thought that Riddler was one of Robin's pet names or whatever the fuck.
Call
it was.
Me Riddler.
And who ever heard of Batman the movie?
I can't call you Riddler. I'd have to start fighting you.
Blow her up. Blowhard is her name.
Adam West. Those weren't even fucking. Yeah, I'll play the Opie.
Hold on. Here's the Daily Leader from RonFez.net. Maybe he's calling to apologize. Go ahead, Leader.
Hey, what are you doing? It's like I've always said. You can't beat Fez. He's the best. Come on. What are you doing disrespecting the guy on his own show?
Oh,
he's the best. I always love Fez. Way to go, Fez.
They all come around. Now they all want to be part of Champion City here.
No, I always was Fez number one. Dave, horrible.
All right. There you have it, but that's good.
Yeah, there's a bandwagon rolling, and who am I to stop it, Ronnie?
No. Very surprising. That means the Fez versus Dave is back on. Let's find out what today's topic is going to be. What did we play last time? How many did you have to have?
We had to play 2-7, and it was Batman movie trivia.
Batman movie trivia was the last time.
Oh, yes.
This time.
1-7-1.
Before I'm even going to tell you what this is on, what would you guys like the bet to be between each other?
Oh, man.
Loser does what?
Let's see. Go shirtless the rest of the show.
Please stop it. Dave, loser does what?
I like to kiss my ass because we didn't do it last time. I think kiss my ass is really apropos.
All right. Kiss my ass. Chris, topless or topless? I'm not even... But that doesn't come. It's like kiss my ass. Let's find out
all right.
What today's topic is going to be. Star Wars trivia.
Yes.
And I'm going to have to warn you guys this. I'm going to mispronounce a lot of these faggy names.
Alright.
I don't watch all this pussy stuff.
No, it's
and
not.
The questions themselves, and HDG came up with this contest. She says, I love when they fight against each other. It really makes me laugh when Dave loses.
Oh, Jesus.
She did a great job on the Batman trivia.
Yeah. She says, as you know, I've had long time troubles with Dave.
I know. Apparently.
No.
This time I'm going to win, baby.
Mm. All right, Dave, let's hear your cowbell. Fez, let's hear yours. All right, you can hear the difference between those. You're going to be the judge on that since I'll be reading. Listen for the sound at all time, Chris Stanley. So far, there have been 6 Star Wars films. Give them to me in order. And the year they came out.
Star Wars, Episode 4, 1977.
Empire. Give me the entire title, please.
Star Wars, Empire Strikes Back.
Well, give me the entire title of the first one.
Star Wars Episode 4, A New Hope.
Right.
1977. Star Wars Episode 5, Empire Strikes Back, 1980. Star Wars Episode 6, Return of the Jedi, 1983.
Right.
Star Wars Episode 1, Phantom Menace, 1999. Star Wars Episode 2, Attack of the Clones, 2000. Star Wars Episode 3.
2000 was your answer?
Yes. Star Wars Episode 3,
Revenge of the Sith,
2001.
Because you, my friend,
I know.
Made a correction.
I know.
Fez Watley. Yes, you don't have to hit. You don't have to re-hit.
All right, Star Wars Episode 4, A New Hope, 1977.
Correct.
Star Wars Episode 5, The Empire Strikes Back, 1980. Star Wars Episode 6, Return of the Jedi, 1983. Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace, 1999. Star Wars Episode 2, Attack of the Clones, 2002, I think it was.
That is correct, and you have one more, Fezzy.
Star Wars Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith, and that was 2007.
So close. 2005.
2005, shit.
Yeah.
I thought it took longer.
2005.
For some reason.
I Lord of the Rings did. I did back to back summers.
You guys sure knew the early ones. And then you, of course, both remembered when they came back. Fez had the 2002. Star Wars Revenge of the Sith, 2005. Okay. 2005. All right.
Jesus, he took a long time.
3 years, it's not bad.
Yeah, I guess so.
I thought it was longer, actually.
But here's the problem. He took 3 years between every movie. So if you were remembered the first movie and then 3 years, you would have been perfect. And he's very anal about that kind of stuff. Almost superstitious.
Fuck. All
right. Again, I'm going to fucking say a lot of words wrong
here. That's okay.
What is the number of the asteroid droid Obi-Wan takes with him in his interceptor to Yutabu? Is that it?
I don't know. Okay. I'll say, you know what, this is a guess, but I'm going to say R2-D4.
R2-D4. Fez.
I'm just going to say R9.
Listen to this. R4-G9. You both had a little bit of it.
I knew it was like, okay.
What is the name of the other hut with Jabba as he's watching the pot? Fezzy.
Gardula. Gardula the Hut.
That is the full name.
Oh.
Gardula the Hut. This is a Kiss My Ass match on its way to be even something bigger. These guys are going to put together something bigger, but as of right now. And again, I'm going to say these words really bad. What Jedi does Darth Vader kill on Kashyyyk between episodes 3 and 4?
Episodes 3 and 4, okay.
Between 3 and 4. Don't know.
Rone Shrine.
I don't think I've ever even heard that name, maybe.
What color should a Sith Lord's lightsaber be? Fezzy.
Red.
I had that.
What color lightsaber did Luke have in return? Davey Mike.
Green. All right, on the board.
What kind of gas is mined on the Cloud City at Bespin? Bespin.
Euphorium?
I'll just say carbonite.
That's the fucking spot you and I do. Yes, it's carbonite.
Yes.
No, it's not, you idiot. It's Tibana gas. What does TIE, T-I-E, stand for as in TIE fighters? Dave.
Transport Imperial Empire? Because they're ships.
Fez.
Tiny Imperial Enemy.
The Twin Ion Engine.
The Twin Ion Engine, eh?
Yeah. What was the fake title of Return of the Jedi? Yes.
Revenge of the Jedi.
What was the fake title of Return of the Jedi that was used to keep fans away from filming location?
Wow, I don't know. Attack of the Tauntauns.
Fuck me.
I have no idea.
Attack of the Tauntauns is absolutely... What is it?
Can I steal again?
Yeah, no.
A Blue Harvest.
Yeah, you're right.
Fuck!
We're never going to make it to 7. This is really, really bad.
We're at 2-1 right now in favor of Fez.
Damn it. I knew it, too. Shouldn't have jumped in so early.
Who was the only human to fight in and survive 2 Death Star battles? Davey Mack.
Wedge Antilles.
Did you know that one, Fez?
Yeah.
Keep it calm.
Han Solo did not carry a lightsaber. What was the only time he ever used... Wait a minute, who got that?
I heard Fez hurt first.
Oh, that's bullshit!
I would have said Dave,
dude,
but...
fucking bullshit!
It was to save Luke on Hoth when he cut into the Tauntaun.
That's...
And I will tell you the truth.
Be a gentleman.
What's that?
I hit that first, Ronnie. I'm not fucking kidding.
I thought that you hit it first, but I'm not the judge. I'm going by sight. Chris Stanley went by sound.
That's bullshit, Pep, but whatever.
You asked him to be a gentleman? Did he answer you?
No, Fez should be a gentleman and admit if I hit first.
I'm being a gentleman. Let the judges decide these things.
Wow.
Okay, so I hit it first, but that's all right.
What is the name Princess Leia got from her adopted family? Baby Mac.
Organa.
What's the score now, Fez?
It is tied up 3-3.
Wow, this would have been 4-2 if Pepper didn't cheat him. Whose body is rushed under the foot of the Imperial Walker?
Whose body is crushed?
Dax.
Dak. No plural.
I'm going to go to the judges.
I have no clue what the answer is.
The way it's spelled is D-A-C-K. I don't know how it's pronounced. Is it Dax or Dak?
No, it's Dak. It was pronounced Dak.
That's Dave's.
Dave gets it. What body element can feel the force? What body element? Yes, Dave.
Ion.
The blood.
Midi-chlorines. Midi-chlorines.
Oh, stupid. I'm so stupid.
If you remember, they talked about that.
Right.
Yeah.
Shit.
What planet did Anakin and Obi-Wan have their final battle in Return of the Sith? What planet? Fezzi.
Mustafar.
Is correct. What is the score, Fez?
It is tied up again, 4-4.
4-4, and we're running out of questions. And running out of questions fast. Who kills Jedi Master Yarel Poof? The Jedi Master. Davey Mac.
Anakin Skywalker / Darth Vader.
The Emperor.
This is General Korda. General Korda.
General Korda. Okay. Okay.
Where does bounty hunter Ara Singh appear in The Phantom Menace? The bounty hunter, Ara Fezzi.
On Coruscant, talking to Palpatine.
What exactly is happening?
It's like in the, during one of the votes, during one of the,
Davey Mac.
When Senator Palpatine is talking to Queen Amidala, he appears behind Senator Palpatine.
Well, what is happening at this thing? Because I don't know all these fucking facts.
They're taking
something's going on at the time.
They're taking a vote.
It's a pod race. A pod race is what I have.
That's right.
What is Han Solo's response to Leia's profession of love? Does he?
I know.
Done exactly like him. I know. Darth Vader tells Admiral Mahdi that the Death Star's ability to do what is insignificant. Davey Mack.
The Death Star's ability to do this universal terror that you've constructed is insignificant in to the thing of the Force. The ability to destroy a single planet is insignificant.
Way to work through it.
Wow.
Way to work
that
through it.
That was millionaire-ish.
That was way to work through it.
It was a millionaire.
What do we got on score, Fezzi?
Tied again, 5-5.
And we are running out of questions. How many Oscars did New Hope win? Yes, Dave.
One.
Fezzi?
I'll say 2.
6.
Really?
What does technical? Technical.
Yeah, okay.
What does Luke Skywalker threaten Jabba the Hutt with just before he plummets into the Rancor pit? Yes.
He says, my friends will come and kill you.
He threatens him.
He says, you've seen your last day.
With a blaster. With a blaster.
Oh. Oh.
Okay. That threaten seems like a verbal thing. But all right, I get it.
He threatens him with
a
blaster. Yeah. We may be just out of questions at 4-4 because you guys
5-5
5-5 You've missed a hell of a lot more than you guys have gotten.
I actually knew Blue Harvest and Pepper stole one from me. Damn it!
That would have been 6 right now.
And I fucking...
we're running in some other questions. True or false? Darth Vader is the one who said, Luke, I am your father.
True.
He didn't say those exact words. He said, Luke, Obi-Wan never told you the truth. I am your father.
He actually, if you would have just said false, I think I'd have gave it to you.
Uh-huh.
But he actually said, no, I am your father.
But...
here we go. No, it's not the same thing. We're going specifically here. By the way, we're off the real stuff.
Okay.
We had 28 fucking questions, and you idiots couldn't fucking answer it on your own. So we're scrambling.
It's very intense.
In The Empire Strikes Back, what food did Yoda cook for Luke? Davey Mac.
A stew. A snake stew.
I'm going to say it was a root stew.
Oh, no way.
A root leaf stew.
Yeah.
What Star Wars movie had the most lightsaber battles? Who are you giving that one to?
Dave.
Wow.
Revenge of the Sith. Star Wars Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith.
Where are we on score?
6-6
Gentlemen, we're playing this way. You got to win by 2.
Okay, great.
These are Twin Oaks rules, okay? Right. We're in Chichester now.
Okay, I like
not
that.
Not in Jersey.
No, Jersey's win by 2. I like it. Thank you. We're going to fucking Roddick Federer this thing.
Mm, really?
Maybe.
Is that how we're going with this? This one, name the only two Star Wars movies where the word lightsaber is not used. Hold on for 1 second. I want to just make sure. Okay, go ahead, Dave.
I want to say Star Wars Empire, Episode 5, Empire Strikes Back. And I'm going to also say Star Wars Episode 2, Attack of the Clones.
Fezzy, your chance to steal.
I'm going to say Episode 5, Empire Strikes Back, and Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith.
It is Episode 5
and
Episode 1.
Fuck. Concentration.
In what Star Wars prequel can the Millennium Falcon be seen in the back? Yes.
Star Wars Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith. More dids. This is the most intense thing of my life.
Yeah.
This is the most intense moment
in my
life.
It's a kiss my ass match.
Breathe.
All right, you two faggy geeks. What creatures do sand people ride? Call it out. Call it out, Chris.
Dave.
Ooh. Dave, what creatures do sand people ride?
Sand people ride.
3 seconds.
The.
2-1
Tusken Raiders.
Not the Oakland Raiders.
Bantas.
Tell the guys to get on the fucking questions. Because we're very, very deep.
It is 7-7 again.
What is the first sentence in the yellow text of the opening crawl in episode 4, A New Hope? Yes, Dave.
It is a time of rebellion.
It is a dark time for the galaxy.
It is a period of civil war. Who composed all the music for every... Call it, Chris.
Dave.
John Williams. Wow.
This is for the win. This is for the win. And at this point, I will already have run out of questions again. Which Star Wars movie had an EU character, Prince Exegor, in the background for a few seconds? Fez Watley.
I will say that that was Star Wars 3, Revenge of the Sith.
Dave McDonald, for the win. Do you even know who this prince is, Fez?
Yeah, this was from a story that took place in between episodes, from a book that took place.
All right, Davey Mack, just a few seconds.
Well, Ronnie, I'm debating between episodes 1 and episodes 2,
mm-hmm.
Okay? Because it clearly wasn't in episodes 4, 5, and 6. So the debate is, where would the EU have been? Episodes 1 or 2? Now, I don't recall... Episode 2 needing a prince. Therefore, I'm going to say Episode 1 of Phantom Menace.
This would be for the win. And Fez would have to kiss Dave's ass. And the winner will be announced when we come back from this commercial break.
No!
I'm only kidding.
Yeah.
Tried to Ryan Seacrest shit.
Best day of my life.
Woo!
Son of a bitch.
I think we went through like 40 questions. Way more, because we had a lot of left over for Batman.
Yeah, it was 9-7, so...
What was the big difference for you in that one, Fez?
I think there was more behind-the-scenes questions, like Oscars and, you know, the Blue Harvest thing.
Dude, that was after we fucking missed so many questions. We went way deep. I was just going to start making me easy.
I felt good with this one. I knew Blue Harvest, and what I did, Mr. B, is I didn't let my setbacks shake off my game.
Like you did last time?
Like, yeah, the New York Football Giants in the Super Bowl, you know, they got down, but Eli still took them back. Well, I didn't let the setbacks get me down. I said, fuck it. I knew Blue Harvest, and the one answer, I definitely was first, but I decided to overlook it and keep playing. Positive mental attitude, PMA.
And also, I was not able to build up a big lead like I had in the Batman one, so nerves were totally getting into it on me.
Oh, is that right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, the tension was thick.
It was thick.
You seemed smooth, but I'll tell you something, Fuzzy. After fucking Dave reamed Chris Stanley on an obviously bad call early on, seven fucking close calls in a row went to Dave. You wonder why fucking John McEnroe would scream at the fucking ref.
Right.
Because at that point, he was petrified to give one close call to Dave.
Well,
Fez.
I feel like my buzzer ability has always been, even on Dark Knight, I feel like my buzzer ability is a little bit stronger. I just didn't know the questions on Dark Knight.
Yeah.
This time I knew the questions, so it suited my buzzer ability just fine. But I was also early a lot. You know, I fucked up the Blue Harvest thing because I was too fast on the buzzer. So, like, that's a good thing and a bad thing. I fucked up the Darth That's, Vader.
We weren't talking about any of that. We were talking about you intimidated Chris Stanley after
glaring at him through the window.
An obvious blown call. And he wasn't paying attention. So after that, he's like, Wally's not going to scream at me. I'll give it to Dave. Because every time I would look over at Fez, and Fez would just be like, I don't know, I guess Chris Stanley, we got to believe. This is why the bad boy does well for himself.
I felt like those were legit calls.
You wanted it more, is my only point. Because Fez, you did very, very good on the information. At least, you know, if you would have gotten half those calls thrown your way,
right,
you probably would have either won this or we'd still be going.
True. But then I also got screwed out of a call.
You did. There's no doubt about it.
But that was exciting as hell. That was one of the greatest victories of my career.
Well, one thing I had to do was, like, with the Banta one, that was one of the close calls that went to Dave. I didn't know that answer until I thought about it.
I thought everybody knew Banta. That's one of the few I knew.
I fucked up.
That was like when even, like, little kids know the word Banta.
Yeah, right.
I just fucked my head up there.
Here's our good friend, the Radio Shark.
Hey, even though Fez lost and has to kiss Dave's ass, doesn't he still win, really?
I guess he does. Radio Shark was very angry with you and sent me an email and didn't bring it up on the air. Very surprised to hear about that.
Hmm.
But he's extremely angry with you, Dave.
There's certain systematic things we need to do to get people in here. Period.
That's not why he's mad at you.
Oh, well then.
But I guess also, like Chris Stanley, he's afraid of Dave McDonald.
I don't see why. I'm very, very friendly to people. Mm. I don't know why he would be upset with me.
So the kiss my ass gets done today. I'm going to make a call here. Since it went back to kiss my ass, Dave also lost to Fez before. You're both kissing each other's ass today at the same exact moment. It's going to be a 69 kiss. But I did find out we were going to make the grand prize, lick my ball sack.
Right.
But, the bosses tell me no. They think that comes along as somewhat sexual. So two kiss my ass pictures will be going today. Should I send it to ronfez.net or?
No. No, don't send it to ronfez.net.
Where would you like it to go?
Send it to Whackbag, somewhere else, not ronfez.net.
Dave, would you like it on ronfez.net? That was always the front cover of everything that we've done here.
Yeah, maybe for Mikey Boy, maybe. I don't know.
I don't see where they deserve it. I don't see where I should send them anything fun.
Well, I don't know where we're going to send the picture then. The Kiss My Ass match, of course, is over. And here's what I decreed. Dave has already owed Fez one, so they will both kiss each other's asses. And then we're going to send the pictures out so they can be viewed. Where do you guys want to do it?
I say Whackbag, not ronfez.net.
Davey?
I guess Whackbag,
it's the first time we haven't sent it to ronfez.net first.
I know.
And here we go. I'm going to give you each of your lists because you for the next contest.
Okay.
This is what Dave's list was. And then Fez, you have to pick one.
Okay.
Dave, then I will read Fez's list. You will have to pick another. And then for the other game show, I'm going to give you guys an assignment, and you're going to have to study that. Something neither of you want.
Interesting.
Okay. I like it. Yeah.
Maybe that'll happen over the break. Maybe even before then. Who knows?
All right, fine.
But this is Dave's list.
Okay.
Rock music.
No, don't like that.
Baseball.
No, don't like it.
Gangster movies.
No, that's the best so far, but no.
Independent film?
No.
Basketball?
No.
And Bob Dylan?
No. I would have if I picked anyone then, it would have to be gangster movies.
You have. You've picked gangster movies. Dave, these are Fez's that he feels strongest about.
All right.
Three's Company?
No.
American Presidents? The Andy Griffith Show?
Okay.
Wrestling?
All right.
Bible trivia.
Okay.
Which, excuse me, sounds like blasphemy. To say that there's something trivial in the Bible, I don't think the Pope would back you up there. That's just trivia. That's just a little pop culture, know-nothing stuff. State capitals and Superman movies.
All right. American presidents.
Really?
Yeah.
All right. There we have it. And then later in the show, we'll be picking out one that you each have to do. Who wants to get their ass kissed first? Who's ready to be the first one to get their ass kissed?
I'll have my ass kissed.
You want to kiss his ass first, Fez?
I'll kiss his ass first and get it over with.
All right, go over there in front of the Ron and Fez sign. Chris Stanley, come on in here. Now, we have to make sure it's just a side picture, really walking the line with these guys, since they thought Lick My Ballsack was somehow sexual. They thought it came across. So, Chris Stanley, come on in. You have your camera?
Yes.
And make sure that you can get a decent shot. Fez, you're down on your knees.
Right.
Davey Mac is that... all right, Davey Mac, you're taking the picture. And Fezzy, this is... make sure that you can get the side view.
Okay.
The side shot there. Hold on. What are we trying to do?
Hit the mic.
That room? Okay. Because I don't want anything looking like it's sexual, but I want the people at home to know.
Right.
You know.
Yeah.
It is a legitimate kiss my ass, much like Vince McMahon does. Now, point to the side so we can get the, you know, the sign in as well. Get it all lined up.
Okay. Wait a sec.
When you
this is a very pale ass I'm staring at.
Well, I'm sorry, it's not something that's up to your...
It's like a goldfish bowl or something. You can actually see things moving around inside.
That's not a good idea.
You can see the blood flowing.
All right, go ahead, Fezzy.
All right. Ah.
All right, switch sides.
These shorts of his have not been to the laundry in months. Just so everyone knows.
Yeah, it's not a shocker.
Oh God, he stinks. He absolutely smells.
Not a shocker.
It's very hot in the city today.
All right, let's.
It's 91 degrees.
It is a hot day.
And I was walking. I always walk from the Port Authority to here.
How long does that take you?
15 minutes. And I get very. I wear jeans, so I get very. I believe the word is swamp ass. That happens.
All right, stop taking pictures because they can't. Would you just pull your pants up now?
I thought we were doing another straightforward shot.
No, I don't want. I just explained a million times. I don't want to get a fucking problem with these guys.
All right.
All right. Now you turn it around and let you got to kiss Fez's ass.
Okay.
Here's Fez Watley in the kiss my ass.
Oh boy, very hairy. Very dark.
Yeah, well.
There's a lot of
get in there.
Okay.
This is for Batman trivia. What are you doing? He's got his finger in my crack, Ron. Get him out of there.
I just need somewhere to hold. Somewhere to grab.
Fezzy, you're showing off a little turf there, too, in the front.
Oh, God.
Oh, am I sorry?
Yeah. I don't want any pictures going to have us trouble.
To get it? Oh. No, that smells bad. That's like the smog in Mexico City.
All right, we're done.
I had Spanish yesterday.
That's bad.
We're done.
That was bad stuff.
All right, let's take a listen to this bit that I guess is this called Fez Opie?
Ron and Opie is okay, the official title.
All right.
So back to school's coming up.
It is.
And I remember the year that I decided I wasn't going to take a lunchbox anymore. I wanted that bag lunch.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no, it cost too much money to get the small brown paper bags for my lunch.
Well, instead of getting the small bags to put my lunch in...
My goddamn lunch. A lousy peanut butter and jelly sandwich and a bruised apple.
Didn't have those. Ended up taking my lunch to school in one of those giant grocery brown paper bags.
A huge... Wallbound paper bags.
also, it just looked enormous and ridiculous.
Now, let me guess. In those days, did your mom used to call you Opie? Because that's history.
Small.
Brown. Paper bags.
866 Ron Zero Opie. That's Ron and Opie. Oh, that was fucking rich. And I don't fucking ever care for anything Dave does. But I fucking nailed you.
Oh, what is so nice is how meaningless the work that must have gone into it, and it means nothing today.
I will say this. It means a lot to me.
It means nothing.
It means a lot to me because I fucking knew you lifted that. How long did it take you to find that bit?
A long time.
Yes, exactly.
3 hours.
But you heard it. It's fucking word for word.
And
it's word for word.
And it's useless. It's powerless today.
I will say this.
It's powerless.
It's powers to entertain.
I will say this. Hit the siren. The score is now 1-1.
No way!
1-1.
No!
Yes!
There is no kiss my ass taking place.
I want to kiss my ass match!
Not going to happen. Unless it's a double kiss my ass, you could either push this aside and say, okay, it's 1-1, or you each kiss each other's ass. Because that fucking thing was exactly what I said it was the other day. And Dave went inside. I got to give it to him. And then we go on to round 3. And it's kiss my ball sack. So as of right now.
Wait, that's the competition?
Yes.
Who wins?
Fez. No matter what happens, Fez wins. Fezzy, he fucking nailed you on that. Nailed you. And that came out of fucking nowhere. I did not expect that today.
I thought it really came up lame, especially after losing 7-1.
But it went go back to what we fucking talked about. You're a fucking bit thief. And I don't care, Fuzzy. I thought it was fucking great. There's no way Opie can find out about this.
This is like Ollie Frazier.
It really is.
This is great.
It's Ollie Frazier.
I'll do double kiss.
This gets fucking, what is double kiss?
I'll do double kiss my ass for the photos.
Well, that would be up to Fez. I feel like today was his big win.
All right, it's all up to him.
I mean, if he wants to kiss your ass, that is up to him. But that fucking bit rocked, Fez. You can't take it away.
I'm not doing double kiss. I'm owed a kiss on my ass.
All right, so you make the rules then.
No, I don't want to do double kiss. I will go for the third round.
All right, so there we have it. That was a fucking great bit, though. You got to give him that.
Oh, I'm not giving him anything today.
That was hysterical.
I feel too good about Batman trivia, Ronnie.
He even lined it up and you were going word for word together. Why didn't you fucking tell me that before the trivia thing? I would have fucking definitely played that.
Oh, I didn't have time.
Why are you so fucking busy? What makes your life so busy?
But I'm glad that Champion City has been restored into the ESD neck of the woods.
Oh, that was fucking great. All right, the next one, it may be baseball. It may be Star Wars.
Baseball.
And you feel like you can beat them at anything now.
Oh, yeah. I feel like I'm on a roll.
So you're not even saying, no, it's got to be Star Wars. You're saying bring on baseball.
I would definitely want it to be Star Wars. That's where I know I could dominate yet again.
Baseball.
You don't know much about Star Wars, right?
I know Star Wars, and I would love to participate in the Star Wars trivia contest. But you brought up baseball.
Why are you fucking talking like Rain Man?
Because he is worried. He is a nervous wreck. He's losing it.
I'm just being a humble competitor.
Rich, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, that was great. I think congratulations is in order. Dave, that was great. You smashed Fez. I loved it.
Well, it was it was a really funny fucking bit. I can't take that from him. And it's only because I remember Opie telling that story and then fucking hearing Fez telling it verbatim as if it was his life. And then you saying, no, Opie's never told that story. And then he goes back and finds it.
I'm sure a lot of people have told that story. I'm sure a lot of people.
That's not what you said the other day.
I'm sure a lot of people have had to carry a big brown an embarrassingly big brown paper bag to school.
Here's our good friend Arch.
The subject for the next tiebreaker will be Three's Company.
Ooh.
Wouldn't mind that one bit, Arch.
Wouldn't mind the Three's Company at all. Wow, what a morning. I did not expect this. They are going toe-to-toe with each other.
A lot of twists.
Yeah, a lot of twists, a lot of turns. All right, we're going to take a break here.